Here we're going to briefly describe the reaction coordinate diagram that is used often in discussing topics in thermodynamics and in kinetics. And what I've shown here is the diagram for an exothermic reaction. Energy is plotted on the y-axis and reaction coordinate, which is essentially the progress of the reaction, where reactants are on the left, products are on the right. This is exothermic because enthalpy of the products less than the enthalpy of the reactants. Right? Exothermic reaction, if we were to carry out at constant temperature, we'd give off heat. Burning something is a very exothermic reaction. That energy comes from taking some of the energy out of the bond, so products have less energy. So delta H, in this case for reaction going from reactants to products, is negative. E sub F is the activation energy for the forward reaction. And so in a rate expression, we'd have a rate constant that has the activation energy in it, and this determines how fast the rate is. This point of highest energy is referred to as the activated complex. So this is something that's not a stable compound. It's something that exists for a very short time in the pathway going from reactants to products. Now, we should also point out in this diagram that if we had an endothermic reaction, it's just the same diagram but going in the other direction. So if this is my reactant, it's going over a much bigger barrier to get to products, but now the products have a higher energy than reactants. So endothermic reaction, delta H is positive, and you can see in this diagram, it's a much bigger barrier than for the exothermic reaction. But both reactions follow the same pathway. This is important, that both the forward and the reverse reactions follow the same pathway. And this means they go through the same activated complex. Now, from this diagram, we could look at a plot of the log of the rate constants for the forward and the reverse reactions. The reverse reaction, this blue line, has a much steeper slope because the activation is higher for the reverse. So reverse is the endothermic, and the forward is the exothermic reaction, has lower activation energy. And this is plotted as 1 over the absolute temperature. These low temperatures, the rate constant for the forward reaction is much larger than that for reverse reaction. Remember, this is a log scale. At higher temperatures, the rate of the reverse reaction is much higher. So this means, for example, at equilibrium, as we raise the temperature, the rate of this reverse reaction increases much faster than the rate of the forward reaction. So exothermic reaction, and we raise the temperature, so the rate of reverse reaction increases much more than the rate of the forward reaction, which means the equilibrium constant decreases as we raise the temperature for an exothermic reaction. Of course, this means for an endothermic reaction, raising the temperature increases the rate constant. Now we can understand this change in equilibrium constant from the change in the rate constants based on this diagram, where the activation energies for endothermic and exothermic. So exothermic reaction, the activation energy, endothermic, larger activation energy.